Hello everyone, welcome to SQL Repository and you are watching Module 7.5 Data and Log Directories. In this video, we will discuss the data and log directories and the files inside it. So for this, let me navigate to the data directory first. For this, I will write ls and then the path of data directory, which is var lib PostgreSQL 15 main. Hit enter and you can see couple of directories here, but I want you to concentrate on only three directories, which are base, global and pg underscore wall. So let me first navigate to the base directory first. Okay, and you can see couple of folders here and the name of these folders are just numbers. And these numbers are actually the database IDs and you can get those IDs from pg underscore database table and then map the database with these directories. So each directory represent a database, a user database. Okay, let me go inside one of these directory. And here you can see a couple of files and then some of the file names has just numbers and then some of them has underscore FSM and underscore VM. So the files with just numbers are actual table data and the file with underscore FSM is free space map, which keeps the track of free space for each table. And then the file with underscore VM is visibility map that contains tuples that are known to be visible to all active transactions. Okay, now let me go ahead and navigate to the global directory. And global directory belong to Postgres internal and you cannot write any user data there. So this is all Postgres internal tables, mainly the PG catalog tables and PG, you know, PostgreSQL will write these files internally and ideally you should not touch this. Okay. So now let me go add my last folder. You know, I want to navigate the last folder, which is PG underscore wall. And here you can see a couple of files and a folder. So I don't have the archiving enabled yet. So I can see a couple of log files, but after a certain time, these log files will be deleted and new log file will be created. But if you have archiving enabled, then it will move to the archive folder and it will actually not be deleted. So this is very much important for point in time recovery, but I don't have the archiving enabled yet. So in my case, it will be deleted after some time, but in the upcoming videos where I will enable the archiving, I will cover this again. Okay, these are the binaries, so you cannot directly read it. So if you try to open these files using cat command or tail command, this is not going to work. Okay, now, as I said, in the base directory, you have folders for each database. And how exactly we can relate these folders with the database? So for this, I will connect to PostgreSQL instance. And here I will write one command, which is select star from pg underscore database, hit enter. And here you can see those numbers. So for DVD rental database, the number is 24890. For the other databases, the number are different, but this is the folder which we have navigated to check the files. And this folder belongs to DVD rental. So this is how you can, you can find the OID of the database and you can relate those directories with the individual database. Now you had many files inside this directory where you can just see the numbers. So which file belong to which table? If you want to know that, for this, you will have to write the query. So let me actually navigate to the user database first. So the DVD rental database, and I have a couple of tables here. So suppose I have a table name actor and I want to find the file name for this actor table. For this, I can write select star from pg underscore relation underscore file path, and then you will have to provide the name of the table, hit enter, and it says so the base directory and the database folder, which you already know, and this file 32770. So let me quit from here and hit up arrow. And from here, I will copy this. Actually, I should not copy the file name because I cannot list the file name. I can only list the directory and hit enter. Okay, so here I am interested in, okay, I forgot the number. So actually, let me go ahead and find the number again. PSQL, navigate to DVD rental, and then, yeah, so 32770. So I must find this folder here, 32770. So this is the folder, this is the file, and this file belongs to Acta table. And if I want to check for any other table, like I have a table with name film. Similarly, I can check the file name for this table, which is 24937. So you should ideally find it somewhere here. Because all the files are placed inside this, I don't have any other table space. And if you want to check the table space, you can find in the table pg underscore table space, hit enter. So you can see two table spaces here, pg underscore default and pg underscore global. Pg underscore global is for the internal tables and it will always write inside the global folder. But for pg underscore default table space, the default file path is your base directory. And as I don't have any other table space, so all the tables are actually placed inside that directory and using this table space. But in next few videos, I will cover table space again. And then you can see we will create another directory. And then we will create the tables in the different directory and the table space for those tables will be different. Okay. But for now, I only have the default directories. And base is the default directory for user and global is the default directory for Postgres internal tables, and the folder name is global, and then pg underscore wall in the same at the same place you will find the folder with name pg underscore wall, and this is where your wall files are placed, and inside this you have one archive folder, but archival is not enabled right now in my instance, but you can use that folder to copy your wall files after a certain time, and it will be useful for the point in time recovery. Okay, so this is what I wanted to cover in this video, and in the next video we will talk about the error log file, and then we will create few errors, and then we will try to check those errors in our error log files. Thank you for watching.